Allahu Akbar.
La ilaha illallah.
La ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Alhamdulillah. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهديه ونحن معهم بفضلك وجودك يا أرحم الراحمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank him. We ask him to forgive us, we ask him to protect us, we ask him to save us from our shortcomings. And all the peace and blessing upon his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran from the beginning to end, he reminds us and advises us and counsels us to have taqwa, to be conscious that the day will come we will answer everything we've done in this life. We will be held accountable to whatever we've done in this life. And the Quran from beginning to end, full of examples of men that have fulfilled that taqwa requirement. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was talking about taqwa, he pointed at his heart. He says, "At-taqwa hahuna." It's in the heart. It's not what you look like. It's not how much you have. It's not the way you speak. It's not the way that people think you are. It is deeper than that. It's who you are as a person. And the best example for the sound heart after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. The greatest men that ever walked this earth, number one is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and number two is Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And we're speaking about them because this is the season for Hajj. This is a sacred month of Hajj. This is the people now going and they are there. Where? Where? They are praying to the same Qibla, to the same direction established by Ibrahim and cleansed and re-established by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, today I'm delivering to you a message from Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah calls him Millata Abikum Ibrahim. Listen carefully, I want your heart to listen to this. This is our father. This is our loving father. He loves us so much. Alayhi salatu wasalam, the Prophet Ibrahim, that Allah calls him, you are the father. And he told us, follow the way of your father. Millata abikum, your father Ibrahim. The way of thinking, the way of life of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. What is the message? Message given by Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam to deliver to every one of us. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam in the Isra, this hadith narrated in Tirmidhi and Sahih al-Albani, inshallah. In the journey, the Prophet ﷺ went up to seven heavens and into Jannah. In the seven heavens, the highest human can imagine, he met the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Two of the greatest human ever lived. They meet. And what they say? The Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam says, أقرأ أمتك مني السلام. Please convey my salam to your followers. I want your heart. This is our father who's already gone to Allah, who's already gone to Akhira, and he is sending a message from there. This is our future. From the future, he's sending a message to us. He says, salam to you if you follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's way. أبلغ أمتك مني السلام وأخبرهم and tell them. It's a very quick meeting with a very concise message. Tell them that Jannah is amazing. Jannah is beautiful. إِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ طَيِّبَةً. Blessing. Full of blessings. No more rocks. No more accidents. No more horrible news. طَيِّبَةٌ تُرْبَتُهَا. That even the soil itself is blessing. عَذْبٌ مَاؤُهَا. The water is amazing. Everything about Jannah is amazing. وَأَرْضُهَا قِعَانٌ. The property of Jannah is so easy. You don't need bulldozers, you don't need machinery to fix it and build. It's just ready made for you. وَغَرْسُهَا. If you want to own it, if you want to get some from Jannah, is to believe in Subhanallah. Allah is perfect. Allah is perfect. When He commands me to wake up and pray Fajr, that is perfect command. I can't disobey that. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, pray five times a day properly, that is perfect. Subhanallah, that is the seeds of Jannah. Walhamdulillah, all praise is due to Allah. Everything He does to me is praiseworthy. That is the counsel and advice from the future, from our Father who already have seen Jannah to us. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah. There is no authority should be above Allah. Not the money, not the family, not the country, not the culture, not the 2017 fashion, not what the people say online, not what the, no. La ilaha illallah. I'm obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why is Ibrahim saying that? Because Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam loved his father more than anything else. He loved his father. He never called him father. He used to hug him and kiss his feet and kiss his hand and says, Ya Abati. Ya Abati in Arabic is like massive, warm, full of love hug. My dear father. Four times, again and again and again and again. Even the father's telling him, I don't want to see you again. If you don't stop, I'm going to stone you. And he keeps saying, سَأَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكَ رَبِّي. Even if you don't want to see me again, look at this heart. I am never going to stop making dua for you. I will pray for you. This is Islam. هُوَ سَمَّاكُمُ الْمُسْلِمُونَ. He is the one that called us Muslim. عليه الصلاة والسلام. He says, the seeds for Jannah, the payment for Jannah, to inherit Jannah, all you need to do is Subhanallah. Walhamdulillah. ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. Allah is greater than all your difficulty. Allah is greater than all your challenge. There is no more difficulty and a challenge like what Ibrahim faced. There is none. Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام did not have a nation, did not have an army, did not have a massive followers. He was one man. إن إبراهيم كان أمة. He was one man nation. One man. They built the raging fire. If you go to the Kaaba and all you worry about is the noise or the crowd or the hustle and bustle of Mecca and you don't think of Ibrahim being inside the raging fire with full trust in Allah. They rage the fire for weeks and he is watching it and he never ever budge. He never says, it's getting serious now. I'm going to be burned for this prayer. He didn't. Even when Jibreel came to help him, he says, Amma ilayka fala, I don't need help from you, I'm all right. Hasbi Allah. Allah is more than enough. Allah is more than enough. Allah is more than enough. Drugs and alcohol and smoking and gambling is not going to make you happy. Allah should be more than enough to fill your heart with happiness. Allah should be more than enough to satisfy your problems and to fix it for you and to bring ease in a difficult time. This is Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam in the fire. His father was amongst those who were participating. I want you to imagine the love he has for his father and the pain his father is causing him. And he's still making dua even after that. He loved his, he didn't have a children. He prayed, can you imagine how much Ibrahim alayhi wasalam prayed to have a child? And when he has a child, and I can't imagine the happiness. Nowadays, we're so happy to have a child. In the old days, it was everything to have a child. From a princess. Hajar was a princess from Egypt. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to take them and leave them. Abandon them. Subhanallah. What kind of heart Ibrahim had? Instantly, quickly, immediately, he doesn't even explain to the family the journey. He take them in the middle of nowhere. There's no even roads. There's no roads that he will leave them on the road for somebody to pick them up. No, he leaves them there. And look at the iman. Look at the iman of the mother. And she says to him, did Allah command you to do this? If it's a command of Allah, I will wake up for Fajr. If it's a command from Allah, I will pay my zakah. If it's a command from Allah, I will read my Quran. If it's a command from Allah, I will come to the masjid. I will come to the masjid, brothers. Wasn't just a prayer 5 times. Wasn't just fasting. Wasn't just paying zakah 2.5%. It was leaving his most beloved in the middle of nowhere. And the mother says, if it's Allah's command, don't you worry. Where is the woman who will say that today? Subhanallah. Where? Subhanallah. This is our mother Hajar. And this is our father Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. She said to him, if it's Allah's command, he can't even answer from the emotions. He just nodded. Yes, it's as a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we put our trust in Allah. She said, "Even لَنْ يُضَيَعْنَا." No way Allah will put us in difficulty. You go back to your mission. You have a job to do. And he leaves them behind the mountain and he cries. And he make dua for Allah to provide for them, for Allah to protect them, for Allah to save them. And the answer comes from the seventh heaven with the best angel to come down and not only provide for them, make Mecca the most celebrated place on the face of the earth. Because of the trust. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is not enough. No, when the boy grows up, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ibrahim, everybody sacrifice a goat or a cow or a camel, you sacrifice your son. No hesitation. No hesitation. We have a remote control in our hand with a TV and we hesitate to pray. We hesitate to pay sadaqah, $5 or $10. We hesitate to read Quran because, I don't know, I'm tired, go to sleep. But if it's a game on 3 a.m., oh my, is Arsenal playing? Arsenal playing, you're talking about, I have to wake up and watch that. But wake up for Salah? No, too tired. If I wake up for Salah, I will be having headache all day in the office. I won't be able to function with the customers. That is shaitan inspiration. This is not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's talking to you. It is a shaitan who is telling you that your own decision, your own wisdom is better than Allah's wisdom. Allah is telling him, sacrifice your most beloved son, the one you prayed all your life to have. Now he sacrifices. And he walks in the middle of the desert also, takes him away from the people into Mina, where we throw the jamarat. This is the emotion that should come into the Hajji. You go to jamarat and you must cry. Did a man brought his only son here to sacrifice? And the son says, Ya Abati, oh my dear father, do what you've been commanded. I will be patient, inshallah. The knife is ready. And Allah, I can't imagine how much Allah is amazed at the action of this slave, this human being that have human emotions and love. Allah says, Ya Ibrahim, قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا Ibrahim, you've passed all tests. Ibrahim, there is no more difficult test we can put you through. You are the father of all prophets from now on. After you are now, from only you come the best and the greatest. He has 2 sons, Ishaq and Ismail. All the prophets came from Ishaq and from Ismail after him. That is the prize Allah is giving. Not only that, he is in the seventh heaven now, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in Sahih al-Bukhari that Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he is the father of all the millions and millions of children who die before the age of maturity. Any child die young, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said he is in Jannah, and the father figure is Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Some Sahabi says even the disbeliever children. The Prophet ﷺ said, even the disbeliever children, before they've grown up, before they became mature. This is our father. This is Hajj. This is the time we're living in. This is our example. This is our father. This is Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Prophet Ibrahim in Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us live up to the standard they set for us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us for the challenges we have in this life. Inna Allah malikatuhu yusallun ala nabiyya ayyuhal nabiyy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa taslima. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfiru lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu al-ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. This is the Hajj season, brothers. This is the time where we be careful of everything we do. This is sacred time. If a human being was willing to sacrifice himself, his country, his family, his children for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what have we to say when we can't even sacrifice a little bit of our time, a little bit of our money? Everybody has challenges. Everyone has difficulty. Everyone has his own trials. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam taught us the recipe. He gave us the advice. It is his dua. His dua that we do. رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَتِي. This is the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Oh Allah, help me to establish the prayer. I'm having difficulty establishing the 5 daily prayer. Ya Allah, help me. I'm having difficulty with reading Quran. Ya Allah, help me. There is no other avenue for us but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam have taught us this, to turn to Allah in dua. To turn to Allah and ask him, Ya Allah, bless me by being good Muslim. Bless me by establishing Islam. Bless me by keeping and staying as a Muslim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us like Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam in establishing the prayer. رب اجعلنا مقيم الصلاة ومن ذرياتنا ربنا وتقبل دعاء. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على من عادانا. اللهم صل على نبينا محمد في الأولين وصل على نبينا محمد في الآخرين وصل على نبينا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة.